Well, the bad news right now is that we have actually hit the top coldest so far when it comes to the first half of November. Look, from November 1st through 15th this year, we hit an average temperature around 29.2. Compared to the other records that we've had since 1905, the only two close coldest Novembers were 29.5 in 1981 and 29.7 in 1976. So it has definitely been a cold one, and we actually got a little bit out of that cold, sitting with a high temperature of 40 degrees today and 41 down in Rochelle. So we made it back into the 40s, but only slightly. We quite haven't gotten there just yet. We're currently starting to drop down from those 40s. We're sitting around 35 degrees right now. Winds have started to pick up and some cloud coverage has picked up as well. We can already feel that we're starting to see things starting to feel a bit cooler out there. Now, also, have we not only dealt with a cold half, first half of November, but we've also dealt with a lot of snow depth on the ground. Just so you know, the last 6 days from November the 11th, we have had over an inch of snowfall sitting on our ground. That is the earliest stretch on record for here in Rockford, and it doesn't look like it's gonna be going anywhere. We could see another that depth hitting over 1 inch even for tomorrow. Here's wind chills right now. As you see, our temperatures were sitting in the mid 30s, still sitting a bit cooler. Look at that. Freeport sitting at 23, Rockford sitting at 31 right now, and Rochelle sitting down close to 27 for a wind chill. So it's pretty cold, especially as those winds continue to pick up into the night and as we start to see a system kind of move our way. What's going to happen is you're going to start to see these clouds just off to our west start to work into our area, and these are going to be providing us a chance to kind of regulate some of those temperatures into the night. So for a low temperature for tonight, as we get those clouds in here, mostly cloudy, 27 degrees, we're going to be seeing some late snow developing, especially as we head into Future Track. Now look at Future Track, showing you how those clouds are going to be building into the night. This is around 1:30 a.m. This is the biggest chance we're going to be seeing those clouds in the area, along with the added increase of some rain and snow chances moving in. This is showing you, here's around noon tomorrow. We just see off in the distance some of that rain and snow that could be popping up. And this is all going to be because of the system that we're going to be seeing popping up on the rest of the day. So your Sunday showers, this new upper level trough is going to be moving in, bringing us the chance for some rain slash snow. So overall for tomorrow, 37 degrees, getting close to that 40 degree mark once again, with a mix of rain and snow throughout the day, and it's going to be cloudy throughout the day, even if we don't see any rain. Now here's the other half of Future Track, showing you how that line can be panning out, keeping most of the snow up here based on this Future Track model, and seeing some of that rain kind of creeping in just a little bit later in the day, and even lasting into parts of Monday. So Sunday's shower is going to be a little bit like this, a rain snow mix earlier, and then it's going to be lasting late into the morning, rain showers hopefully in the afternoon, and a few icy spots at time. 7 day is showing after Sunday we get a bit of sunshine in the forecast, but the best news is that we get those 40s starting Tuesday through Thursday. Back to you, Lauren.
Thank you, Tommy. The quarterfinal round of the high school